In this tutorial, I'll show you how to turn regular outfits into ridiculously creative designs using Photoshop and AI tools. It's weird, it's fun, and honestly, it's easier than you think. So let's get started. All right, first, I'll show you how it looks in Firefly. Then we'll take it up a notch with ChatGPT. So open your image in Photoshop. Now, pay attention because this part actually matters. Make sure your aspect ratio is one of these you see on the screen. I'm rolling with 1:1, but hey, you do you. Once that's set, export the image. Now, head over to Firefly. Select text to image. And before you do anything else, turn off fast mode, because we're going for quality here, not speedruns. Then pick the exact same aspect ratio as your image. Since mine's square, that's what I'm going with. Next, set the content type to photo, then upload your image as a reference. Oh, and crank the strength bar to max, because we want this thing to take our reference seriously, not just glance at it like a bored intern. For the prompt, I'm going with a photorealistic pizza blazer made out of cheesy pizza, isolated on a white background. And if pizza isn't your thing, swap it out for something wild. Go nuts with your imagination. Hit generate, and boom, here are the results. If it doesn't look right on the first try, just rerun the prompt until you get something solid. Once you've got something that makes you go, yep, that's the one, download it and bring it back into Photoshop. Now, drag your image on top of the main one. So, I like this one. Yeah, the masterpiece I made earlier. Though, my guy looks like he got slapped by an angry pizza. Anyway, let's remove the background. Just a click, quick and easy. Then I'll mask out everything, except the pizza blazer. Alright, here's the look after masking it properly, but hold up, I'm spotting some rough edges. No problem though, I'll fix them with generative fill. Boom! Now it's looking way cleaner. If you want to take it even further, I'll show you how to tweak the colors, maybe throw in some adjustment layers and finish it off with camera raw color grading. And there you have it, the final look. What do you think? And hey, don't just stop at pizza. Try out some other crazy effects like leaves, oranges, or whatever wild idea you've got. Okay, so keep in mind, Firefly has some limitations when it comes to effects. A lot of stuff gets flagged under their policies and the quality isn't always the sharpest. But if you want almost no restrictions, better quality, and full control, ChatGPT's got you. You can create insane effects, way more freedom to experiment. See that on screen? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. All right, to pull this off, you need to open your image in Photoshop. If your image is wide like mine, we'll need to crop it into a square. Now, make sure your image is unlocked. Then, just go to Image, then click Canvas Size. And here, I'll go with 1,000 by 1,000. And if you've got a vertical subject, use 1,024 by 1,536. Just make sure not to keep it wide. We want to keep the subject in focus as much as possible. Now, if you notice any weird spots around the edges after resizing, just fix those with generative fill. This step really matters. It can mess things up later if ignored. Once it looks good, export the image. Now hop over to ChatGPT, upload your image, and in the prompt bar, I'll type something like, make his outfit made out of cheesy pizza and make it super realistic. Then mention your image ratio and don't forget to ask for the output as a transparent background. Hit generate and boom! The result? Way sharper than Firefly, right? But we've got a problem. The face? Yeah, totally different. So here's how we fix it with good old Photoshop skills. Open the ChatGPT generated image in Photoshop and place it right on top of your main image. Scale and position it carefully so everything lines up. If needed, tweak the posture using the Puppet Warp tool to match it better. Once you're happy with the placement, hide this layer for now and duplicate your background image layer. Now comes the fun part. We need to remove the original guy from the scene. Just select the subject and use generative fill to erase him cleanly. Once that's done, unhide the pizza blazer layer again. Next, duplicate the original image one more time. We're going to extract the head from this version. Mask out everything except his head and neck. Now we've got the head ready for replacement. So mask out the head from the pizza blazer image and carefully place the real head in its spot. Take your time with the positioning, this part's all about precision. Once it looks right, use a soft brush to blend it in seamlessly. Now we're almost there. You might see some weirdness around the neck area, but don't worry. We'll clean that up using generative fill. But before we wrap it up, we need to fix the colors to make everything blend together naturally. So first, I'll select the pizza blazer layer. Go to Filter, and open the Neural Filters. Now you'll see the Harmonization filter. Turn it on. On the right, there's an option to choose a reference image. So I'll pick the background image as color reference. It'll automatically adjust the colors of the pizza blazer layer to match the background. Now, for the output, I'll select New Layer, and then hit OK. Next, I'll select the head layer and do the same thing. But this time, I'll choose the harmonized pizza blazer layer, which is layer 1, as the reference. That way, the head tones will match the blazer layer perfectly. Finally, I'll select the background layer, and again pick layer 1 as the reference to harmonize everything. Once you've done this, all your layers will be color matched and blended together beautifully. Now, rename them and group the old layers for backup, just in case. Now that colors are fixed, let's deal with the neck area. Just use generative fill to clean up any rough patches or mismatches. Okay, it's looking perfect now. For the finishing touch, I'll add a hue and saturation adjustment layer. Fine-tune the colors a bit more. And there you go, it's ready. That's how you make your subject wear a ridiculously crazy outfit while keeping the face and background perfectly intact. And if you want to animate it, there are a bunch of AI platforms like Kling, Pika, and Luma AI, but most of them are paid, so you'll need to explore and see what fits you best. Now go crazy with these tools and take your creativity to the next level. And hey, if you're new here, hit that subscribe button and drop a like to keep the madness going. I'll catch you in the next one.